let's go back, way, way back when I got my first job, and my mother didn't suggest, she told me that I was going to give her 1/3 of my net wages for room and board at home. I was going to save 1/3 of my wages for the future, and that was for college. And then the last third I could spend any way I wanted. And I thought that was so restrictive, and I thought that was terrible that she made me do that. And I found out that I was living pretty darn well on that 1/3, and I didn't need the rest, and had I had it, I probably would have spent it too. So I think that teaches us something, and we teach this in our courses, and that is that there are really three kinds of households. One that spends everything they make and accumulate nothing. One that spends more than they make and accumulate debt. And the last spends less than they make and accumulates assets. No one has ever figured out a better way to become financially secure and successful. So I wish you that.
My parents taught me more through their actions. They never had or used a credit card their entire lives. I remember asking my mom to put something on a credit card once, and she told me that she didn't have one, and she looked at me like I had three heads. They never spent above their means, and that's the most valuable lesson I've ever learned. As a child, I remember trips to the toy store. I could never decide on just one toy, so naturally, I asked my parents to buy multiple toys for me. I remember my mom and dad telling me, "We will have to come back next time and get the other toy. We can't get it today." Why don't you think about it, and if you still want the toy, you can save up your allowance money for it. I was taught that good things come with patience and to be choosy about what you're spending your hard-earned money on.